8-3 to under a minute in the first period, and he's in complete control over the freshman's part. Matt Brown has too much experience for a freshman. That experience last season, despite not being a starting lineup, maybe made Matt Brown a better rusher than he even did start in the lineup. I think that's why he's able to wrestle against guys who are more physical and bigger bodies forces Matt Brown to have better techniques.
Wrestle!
So I think last season, working on his technique is
how you decided on Gingrich today to put him out there?
Well, they just have been pretty even up to this point, so we just had him wrestle. And Gingrich won a close match. They've all been real close, and so he earned that spot himself.
And what does it say, his win today? What does that say about him going forward?
Well, I think success is that builds confidence. It's the greatest builder of confidence. So, I think that's something he hopefully just keeps going. The last time he was in here, he beat a ranked guy too, I believe. So he's doing well. He's very tough, very strong, explosive, as you can see. But for him, I think it's just having success like that that's going to help him build confidence. And once he needs to go out there and have a good time, he's going to do really well.
Alex to be the move all season? Is he going to be the heavyweight
line then? Well, I'm not going to say anything is permanent because, that's the plan right now. Each guy on our team has to keep earning their spot. It's not, nothing's a given. So, he's carrying the ball right now.
How important was it for James English and Fuller Rath to come out there today and wrestle like they did?
They're both tough kids. They had tough opponents, and they had to wrestle well and wrestle their match, and they both did. They did a great job. Volrath upped his offense, which is good to see. And I think that just comes from a desire of wanting to win, and that's so I'm excited for him. And James he's a tough kid. And, I'm really happy for him.
You expect wins from them when they come in here?
Yeah, absolutely. They're you got to believe and expect. First of all, we want our guys to have fun when they're out there, and if they're having fun, they're going to win. So the focus is just doing what they do, having fun, and if you're having fun, you're going to wrestle well. If you wrestle well, you're going to win. So yeah, we expect that.
Cael, this is a little bit of a different question, but so ticket allocation for Nationals, I heard you guys didn't get the amount that you requested. Is that?
Well, I don't think anybody probably got what they requested because it's a smaller venue this year, but we got, I think, a little over half of what we requested. We had 800 plus requests that we, in turn requested, and we got 450 or something like that. So. Yeah, it puts us in a bad situation, and people are upset, and it's unfortunate.
Is that just because of the smaller venue set, or is that?
I believe so. Yeah, I believe so. That's what we've been told. We're doing it like the same thing everyone else is doing, trying to scrap around and collect some more tickets. There just aren't any available. So, we have some upset fans, and there's nothing we can do about it, unfortunately.
Anything new on the Altons?
Nope.
Quentin has been a guy the last couple of seasons. He's kind of, I don't want to say he's hit a lull, early in the season, but he's kind of had slow starts where he's kind of built that momentum toward the second part of the season. This year, he's undefeated thus far. Have you noticed anything about the way he's maybe approaching his preparation, being his senior year?
I think he... You just as the season progresses, you just start to see, the Quentin that can be a national champion. The technique that he's hitting out there today, that's the stuff that's going to win the national championships for him. And I don't want to talk specifically. Everyone knows what he does, but he just seems to get better as the season goes along, and I think that's something. He builds up his confidence, builds up, and So looks like he's doing the same thing again this year. That's not to say, you know, that he, I mean, he's undefeated, yeah, but, you know, when you're a senior and you're a national champion, you don't really judge your, you know, your success on whether you're winning or losing. It's more, you know, for anybody, it's more of a performance base, and his performances are getting better and better.
Do you see a new level of urgency from Matt Brown after the Southern Scuffle loss?
I don't know if I'd say that. I mean, he's just trying to get out there and score quicker instead of just, you know, pulling guys down and, you know, hand fighting with them. Because he's very good at that, and he doesn't need to wear guys out before he can score points. He can go out and score points right away. So, you know, he's just getting out. I think Coach Cunningham's been working on him a lot with just going out and, you know, scoring points and doing what he's doing. And he's been trying to put a lot of time into getting better on top too. And, you know, you can see that. And that, I think that got him in trouble with the scuffle, but, you know, it's in the name of progress, so we're happy.
It's pretty crazy. I mean, it reminded me a lot of the Indiana match, you know, with this explosion of chairs and stuff. And I don't know, that feeling you still can't replace with anything else. It's just so amazing, so.
Almost like deja vu, huh?
Yeah, you could say that.
You know, I think the last time, too, you said you like to wear the guys down, you know, and then the third period, and then you feel that if you can do that, stay close, wear them down, and you've got the advantage. Is that what happened today?
Yeah, definitely. You know, push, pull, and then look for my shot once I start getting tired. And I mean, there's a few things I want to work on is maybe faking a little bit more because or at least some more shots because I need to keep myself from getting hit for stalling. You know, refs will probably still going to hit me for stalling if I'm not shooting. Even though I am doing work, it's just they need to see the offense, so I need to work on that still.
So. John Cael said you and Jimmy wrestled off. What was that match like? I mean, how close was it? Cael said it was a close match.
Yeah, I mean, it was a takedown match. You know, a lot of heavyweight matches are like that. And it was pretty cool. We kind of made it, like, similar to a dual meet. We set up a big mat out in the gym and had the lights off, dimmed down, you know.
Right out here?
Yeah, you know, he wanted to try to make it like a real match, you know, and so we both get the same feeling and stuff.
Did you have a different feeling knowing that you had the spot secured? Do you have a different feeling coming into this match, knowing that it was finally your spot?
I wasn't thinking about that. I don't know, I was mostly focused on coming out here and wanting to win. I mean, I know right after I won the day, that Friday I won the spot, I felt relieved and stuff, you know, finally felt like, okay, finally it's mine. But as soon as that happened, I came back and I started getting ready again for this match, you know. Had to stay on track and stay focused.
Oh, yeah. I mean, you know, I think almost every match this year, people have been, you know, just backing up. And I mean, you know, there's exceptions, but a lot of them, they were just backing up, and I have to do all the work, it seems like. But, you know, I'll get better at it. People did that to me in high school. But, you know, this is college, so it's a kind of a new thing. So getting used to it.
Well, I knew he was getting tired, and I knew... In the first period, I had that fake high crotch to a sweep. So I knew I just got to regroup myself, and then I knew, like, the last 20 seconds, I needed one good shot. So I went to my high crotch sweep. I just made sure I finished it, made it secure, and so I got to take down. So.
Jamie, do you expect a shutout like that?
I mean, that's what I hope for every match, going out there trying to score as many points as I can and, you know, dominate the guy. I don't want him scoring points, so, I mean, as long as I get the W, I guess that's the most important thing, but I'm going to try to shut the guy out every time I'm going to wrestle.
Is there any added pressure when you have Nico and Jordan Conway and then Pierce Hall come out, storm off the wind like that, kind of keep things going?
I wouldn't say added pressure, I'd say it's a motivator more than anything, you know. I see my teammates going out there and they're wrestling great and just going out, scoring points and taking it to them. So I just want to continue the same thing, so it just kind of pumps me up and gets me ready to go.